where we can actually start betting some channel points. I am back, your lovely Indian caster, joined by another lovely Indian caster, Mr. Praneeth Jacobs. Say hi to the stream.
Hello, hello. First cast of the season. I'm hype.
Indeed. Let me turn your volume up, actually. You're kind of low at the moment.
Okay, I see them typing, let's pick Teemo in the league chat, so this is going to be a fun game.
This is going to be a fun-ass game. We had a banger of a game last game. Let me just create a new prediction here. Give a quick 20-minute submission period. Start the prediction. All right, there we go. Y'all can start wasting your channel points, and Brandon Wynn and Wisher Washington can continue to lose his channel points. So we'll see if maybe he can change his twist of fate here. R for draft. Send the link. Actually, we might actually have the link here somewhere.
Yeah, they posted it a little bit ago.
All right. Well, you know, R on draft. So. I've got it. So let's just quickly switch over to the pro draft and jump into this immediately. The Wooper Syndicate versus Name Pending. Lord Wisher, I've all-in'd on the Wooper Syndicate. We can't lose again. All right, you've heard it here, folks. If Wisher bets on a team, the other team wins. So we can expect a quick 20-minute victory from Name Pending here.
That's what we like to see.
It is what we like to see. What are your thoughts on both of these teams, Praneeth?
Well, I've seen scrims from the Wooper Syndicate, and their scrims weren't looking too hot, and that was followed by a lot of defenses from all of their teams saying, oh, we're just trying stuff out, which kind of sounded like they were trying to cover their, they were trying to cover their ass, but I think after watching their first game, that game kind of spoke for itself. They went really, really crazy. Like, everybody on their team performed at a very exceptional level. Josh, obviously, with his 16-1 pop-off on Diana, I think it was. So, and with the other team, I mean, I don't remember their game off the top of my head, but I don't think it went well for them. But I could be wrong on that one. But I think the Wooper Syndicate looks a lot stronger in this game. And I think my channel points will say the same. Let me predict. I'm going to get no return, dude. There's already 60k on Wooper Syndicate.
Is 60k on Wooper Syndicate. It's going to be kind of crazy here. But you know, three bans coming in: Viego, Kai'Sa, Alistar, Seraphine, Hecarim, Udyr. Pretty standard bans overall. Just trying to get the Hecarim and Udyr away from Colma, but critically, they left open up his Olaf, which he had a lot of Smurf performances by chaining together some rather insane synergy with Vinit, which Wooper Syndicate actually has as their support. So. Get to see a lot more support jungle plays coming in, and I'm excited to watch that as Name Pending picks up Rell for Roland Chang with the Fat Wang.
Ooh, I don't know how I'm feeling about that one. I have not seen his Rell, but bot lane's going to be one to watch this game, I think.
Bot lane is definitely going to be one to watch. Be excited to see it. Let's really add a chat source really quickly.
Brandon said if red team loses with Colma Olaf, that it's really a curse. Rell Sivir. I don't know. Let's see what blue side's bot lane response is to that draft. I don't know. I kind of want to see Vinit on that Taric again. He did really, really good with that last time. But they could be looking for a different strategy this game.
Okay, there we go. Twitch chat is in here. All right. As Olaf Zillion is locked in for the Wooper Syndicate, this is insane. They're going all in on buffing up this Olaf with as many movement speed buffs as possible. Is just going to be running people down. Rell Sivir locked in for the side of Name Pending. I'm pretty sure this is going to be maybe a Lethality Sivir coming in, where you just kind of just max out on your ability haste and start spamming your Qs off cooldown. But we'll have to see. I don't know if this is a support Zillion or if it's a mid lane Zillion. A Raymade, I think, plays Zillion, and I don't know if Blue Chez plays Zillion. And, you know, they don't ban Tillia, so Vice is like, hey, why not play some Tillia in the jungle? That is his one trick. He did play to Diamond multiple seasons, but that was in the mid lane, so we'll have to see how he's able to pull it off in the jungle. Malphite banned away from Kagero.
The respect ban. There it is.
Respect ban.
He was going crazy on it last game that they played.
Dude, he was solo killing dog. What can I say?
Dog go bonk.
Dog go bonk, man. Crit go dog.
And Wooper Syndicate banning Diana. Interesting.
Wooper Syndicate is banning Diana.
Josh did say my Zillion is clean, so maybe it is a Munzillion, but we'll see off these next two picks.
It could be. And that is terrain on the Ornn top. That's Victor mid, Zillion support for Josh. Yeah, and the Dyna Echo Bands, those were targeted directly at the biggest of Ichis, a.k.a. Dio Brandon, who is currently the best mid laner VCU. Dio Brandon, a.k.a. Big Ichi, is known to be a very avid Diana and Echo player, so taking away those two picks from him is probably going to go back to a Syndra, although we could maybe see a Yone coming out from Big Ichi. He has a lot of good targets to kill with his Yone ult, and Yone is a pretty good pick into Victor, I think. Actually, he's just a pretty good pick in general. Like, just really strong, broken, brain-dead, easy champion. Don't pick Lucian, don't pick Lucian, don't pick Lucian, says Brandon Wandon in the chat. I don't think this is a Lucian angle. This is probably a Yone from Big Ichi if I've ever seen it. Yeah, I predicted it! It's the Yone!
Hey,
Big Ichi on the Yone, baby! Let's go! Big Ichi on the Yone! Go Yone, pick it. Yes, sir, says Arame in the chat. Wow.
I'm very excited to look at mid and bot lane here. I don't think Karma versus Ornn top lane is going to be anything too fun to look at, but and the champ select has started in the League client.
It definitely won't be. While the champ select's going on, Yoke taking over. I'm going to grab some water because I'm super thirsty.
Yep, you're good. All right. I have no idea what I'm going to talk about, but let's look at Twitch chat. Hopefully there can be some content. All right, let's see. Brandon Winded wishing Washington what a I can't speak, whatever. You're the VCU Grim Reaper. Close enough. I would say Dio Brandon's a more like the Grim Reaper, but hey, it is what it is. The Red Draft to Moore, says the Red Lightning. Let's see. So Red Draft of Rell, Sivir, Talia, Ornn, Yone. I do think their team fight looks a little bit better with that comp. I kind of like the engage and disengage potentials with Sivir, Rell, Talia, Ornn, and Yone's just there for that damage. We'll have to see how mid lane goes. I think that's going to be a very big deciding factor in this game, because I feel like both of those players are going to be very... Can I get a point refund? I think both of those players can be very influential for their win slash loss. I think Karma Ornn is going to be boring, man. What can I say? They're going to be throwing pillows at each other for the first 25 minutes of the game. I'd rather watch. Wait. Why did Kage re-lock in Victor? Nah, someone say psych. They're switching, right? No way. Nah, they're switching. They're switching. It's okay.
All right, I'm back.
Kage re-locked in Victor, so I'm kind of just hoping they're switching.
I think they probably will be switching. Actually, that might be a Victor top for Kage. What if that is a Victor top for Kage?
That puts a wrench into this game. I think 79k channel points might be going down the drain if we don't have Josh on Victor this game.
What if it's a Karma top from Kage Ro?
That's what I thought it was.
Karma versus Ornn ranges better. God, I hope so. This game will be cleaner than the last game. Dude, last game was a banger. Both teams were losers that game. Nobody deserved to win that.
Dane almost spelled my name right, but he said I'm a little bit quiet compared to you.
All right, I will turn up your volume then. All right, how about now? Say something.
Yeah, hello, hello. Is it better? Let's hope.
Oof.
I'm not seeing many... Okay, I saw Vineet and Josh swapped there, but... Let's hope for... If Josh isn't on Victor, I feel like they're throwing away a free win. Not saying Josh's karma isn't any good, but I'm just saying his Victor is significantly better. But we'll see what happens over the next few seconds. I think the limit on switching in tournament draft is like below 20 seconds. Oh, they're just having fun now. They're giving everyone a run for their channel points right now.
Are indeed giving everyone a run for their channel points. We've got 3 minutes left before the Or, you know, wait, who's dodging, man? Oh, my.
Because they forgot to switch back. Josh was on Olaf.
Kolma is inting, bro.
Get me a new team.
I was gonna go to the bathroom, man, in the 3 minutes, but it's fine.
Unlucky. There's Daniel in the chat. Hey, Dane, this should be illegal. They should lose a ban. I mean, it wouldn't be a VCLCS game if we didn't restart the champ select at least 3 times, so. I bet they're gonna mess it up one more time and we'll get it right the next. So. Let's see what happens. I have a question. Can you close the channel point prediction thing, like, before the timer runs out?
Yeah, I can. Just go to creator dashboard right. And then the prediction.
Word. I might just put, I'll put in 5k to the Whooper Syndicate. Hopefully I can make a tiny bit of return. And hopefully I don't go 25k down from where I was like a week ago.
Put 5k into Whooper. I wish I could bet channel points, but sadly I'm a mod down. on my main Twitch account, and I run the VCU Esports Twitch account, so it's like, I mean, I can't bet channel mod. Points, but, you know, I can gain happiness from watching Brandon lose his channel points, so.
That's fair enough. I like Red Draft, says Dane. I think Red Draft looks better on paper.
It definitely does. I think on paper Red Draft looks a lot better.
I think the people and the communication behind a blue team is definitely going to show a lot more than it will on red team.
It will. And we've seen situations in VCLCS where, yeah, comp matters a lot, but like sometimes when there isn't communication or anything, things just go down the drain. I think ex-member of Gum Squad, Praneeth Jacob, could you attest to that?
Absolutely. When there's... If someone misclicks their deafen button for 25 minutes of the game, you know, it is what it is. You just have to play without it. But it's a lot harder to do when you're not able to talk to your team.
Yeah, maybe finally we'll be able to get in. So that is Zillion for Blue Chez, Karma top, and then Olaf. They really are just going to be piling on the speed boosts for Olaf here. So a lot of focus onto Kolma this game. But that begs the question, will it leave bottom 3 ADC, Araymate, and Blue Chez out to dry when this Yone eventually, at some point, just goes in with his R and one-shots 3 people at once?
Never know. Could be a field goal type of game for him, but
it could be a field goal type of game.
Could see it again. I really want to see at least one bomb delivery run for this Olaf with the Zillion bomb just running into their backline with it.
For sure, man. That would be pretty funny. I would be surprised if they're not going for that this game. Definitely at least once they should be going for it.
But yeah, I think. I don't know. We'll really have to see how. I think top lane's kind of going to be a stalemate. If something interesting does happen there, then I don't know. I'm wrong, I guess, but I don't think that's going to be interesting to at least 15, 20 minutes. And by that point, they'll be kind of moving around, roaming and such. But I think mid and bot is going to be definitely where all the action's at. I don't know what type of leash and collar Vinit has on bottom 3 ADC this game, but we'll see what it's going to be.
What type of leash and collar? I feel like bottom 3 ADC, I mean, Vinit's like, knowing Vinit is going to, he's going to hit level 3 and then bottom 3 ADC is going to be in a 1v2 lane for the rest of the game, so. Thing is, it's bottom 3 ADC, it's not Tony. Tony could 1v2. But can bottom 3 ADC 1v2? That's the real question. Probably not. Not against Rell Sivir. So, I mean, I'm curious to see how this
Absolutely
goes.
Absolutely not. Sorry, I dropped something. But yeah, I don't think... Obviously, the leash and collar on bottom 3 ADC is attached to that tower, hopefully, but, you know, he's been known to break loose of it once or twice a game. We'll see if red team can take advantage of that. He can't 1v2 when he's 1v9. Yeah, it looks like most of the chat is on board with red team's draft, but most of the channel points is definitely on board with blue team, so we'll see what happens there.
Your mic is still quiet, apparently, and you're at 200% for me, so.
I can turn up my Discord input, we'll see.
Yeah, try that.
I won't do a lot, I'll do like that. Is that better?
A little bit higher, maybe.
I'm not trying to talk too loud, because my parents are going to go to sleep soon.
Okay, yeah, fair enough.
Or they're already asleep, but...
Okay, yeah. Yep. I mean, I think it's fine now.
Alright, just we'll see it in chat if it's not.
Yup. Terms of channel points, 84.2k versus 10.2k. A lot of faith onto the Wooper Syndicate. We did see Wandon say he was going all in, so...
He did say, I can't be wrong again, and I think maybe if I send Josh a DM real quick, he might be able to help us prove you wrong. But we'll see. No, I'm excited. This game's gonna be a good one.
I think it is. I think it's teamwork versus a draft in this case, I think.
Mm-hmm. Lots of teams from what we've seen so far, lots of teams can take notes on how this game is about to go.
Right. Lord Wisher, I can't be wrong again. What if Wandon just loses his bet again? Like, how funny would that be?
I think it'd be even better for the... Let's see, who put 6k on that? Charlie put 6,000 onto Name Pending, and it's a 1 to 9.3 return. So he would make quite the
profit. He would make some bank, bro. He would make some bank. Big Ichi correctly opting for a Fleet Footwork Yone. I do like to see that. To Victor, you kind of do need that fleet.
Yeah, that's definitely a tough lane. But we'll see how he manages to play it. We do see the Dark Harvest on Sivir, so it's definitely going to be that lethality you were talking about earlier.
Yeah, for sure. All right, let's turn off the predictions and submissions since the game has started. And now we will jump right into it.
Let me turn all of my things on, drop that. Alrighty. See, and we do see red side looking for an engage on the top, or an invade on the top side. They're all pathing there. We'll see if anything actually ends up coming of this. I do like the Sivir in front. Oh, okay, they're changing it up now, having Rel go up front.
Alright, looking for an invade through top side. Reminder to fix scoreboard. Thank you very much for that, Dane. I will do that right now. Alright, scoreboard has been fixed. It's like they're going aggressive onto Kage Road, but a quick Mantra Q will prevent any further chase onto the Karma.
As we do see Yone opting for the D-Shield start as well. He's really going to be looking to play very safe this lane, which I think is the ideal process. Victor, however strong he is, does need his Hextech upgrades in order to be, you know, that broken Victor we've seen the Synapse plays, so... Preventing him from getting any early kills and just trying to out-sustain him in lane is definitely going to be on your plus side.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, Victor definitely needs his upgrades. I would have liked to see a second wind and a shield bash coming in for Yone, but... I mean, up to him at that point as to whatever he wants to do. It is what it is.
Yep.
But that would give him, like, a little bit extra survivability in lane. Not yet poked out too... badly by Victor, so but you know, Big Ichi with the big balls goes for the domination here instead.
Yep, and he's just taking all the damage in order to get those few minions, but I mean, that's where the fleet kicks in, that's where the built-in lifesteal kicks in, so the Doran's shield as well. Yone went overheal and started W. Yes, Brandon, that did happen. Your eyes are not playing tricks on you. Are you regretting your channel points? Your bet is suddenly looking good. Love to see it. Zillion and Sivir, both about 70-ish% HP. So already, don't really know what happened there. And Josh just relentlessly putting lots of poke onto that Yone.
Yeah, I mean, it's not like Yasuo who can just, like, permadash onto him, but, you know, the knockup has come through. Vice misses the Talia knockup on a CC target. My guy, that is not it, Chief. That could have been a flash or a kill onto the victor, but, you know, guess not.
Yeah. That was a very max range. He was in the air.
Brother, he was in the air.
It was quite the max range on AQ, so maybe he wasn't expecting it to hit, but you gotta wait those out, my man. Come on.
My man, my mon, can't speak properly.
My mon. Yeah. English second language, you know what it is. And we do see them, the junglers, meeting at top scuttle. Don't think anything's coming to that. I think red team's just giving it. And we did see Victor flash burned mid as Vice kind of just walked into him and Victor was in the wrong spot of the river. And Yone looks like he's going in mid here. Really good trade for him.
Yeah, I mean, once he gets the distance and starts running Victor down, Victor doesn't have spells to trade back or doesn't have the phasers. That's Yone's cue to go in, so... Well played trade. Bode Kinkajou going aggressively onto bottom 3 ADC, but is on the losing end of that trade. Lots of trades happening in the top lane as Terrain takes a lot of damage from the Karma. Bode Kinkajou dies pretty much solo to MF. What are you doing, my guy?
Well, it is the problem with the Sivir right now.
Biggie Chief might be going down here. Kolma is around the corner to pick him up. The Undertow lands. Vice is here for the counter gank. He'll just opt to not keep going forward. Although, you know, maybe he could have gotten the kill onto Yone. Kagero clapping in these matchups, dude.
And Vice managing to take the big Raptor, making them just about even in CS as Olaf did opt for the full clear there. And did get a top scuttle as well. And okay. Terrain looking for some poke back, but just that area is doing a lot of work for Kage.
He should just be farming safely under his tower at this moment. Like, yeah. You're never gonna. He is doing all right in CS. He's even with Kage in a pretty unfavorable matchup early game for Ornn. Big Ichi using his E to farm, but decides, you know, I'm kind of taking a bit too much poke. Let's try and get it back off here.
Josh is just getting gapped. Hot takes from Wisher. Oh, little mistiming on the Ornn engage there.
So maybe be a solo kill from Kagero? Never mind. The Mantra Q hits the minions instead of Terrain here, saving the Ornn's life. Bottom 3 ADC currently sporting an almost 15 CS lead over Bode Kinkajou. Biggest of Ichis comes back with a Berserker's Greaves cast, starting to get the attack speed down. Let's see what they continue to go towards here.
Do you see maybe a three-man top here?
Vice
looks like Kage just might
onto
be caught
Kage.
Out here.
Yeah, I mean, he's caught out. Yone ult comes in. That's a bit of overkill, but I think you take those regardless.
Think that was worth. Well, it was worth, obviously, because they got the kill, but they are down quite a few. They're down one ultimate too many. I don't even think they had used either of them, realistically, but... We will see if that affects them over the next few minutes. Yone does have quite the item advantage over Victor, with just Victor having an amp tome right now, so... That is making his trades in the mid lane favorable, that D-Shield and Fleet Footwork definitely kicking in.
Yeah, for sure. Alright, Big Ichi going aggressive onto a Raymate in the mid lane. A Raymate gracefully dodges the Q, but that was a favorable trade for Big Ichi. At some point, once Yone has enough attack speed, it doesn't need to land Qs, just press right click. And, you know, Big Ichi winning out on that one. Currently up close to 20 CS on the Victor. Uncharacteristic of a ranged versus melee matchup, but Big Ichi flexing his muscles here.
No corrupting from Josh was very greedy. I have seen corrupting on Victor a lot more frequently than I've seen D-Ring, but interesting Orin E, but looks like the top trade is gonna come to an end unless.
No, looks like Torain could be looking to get a solo kill on Kage here. Kage dropped to very low.
If only he had the
health.
Orin ultimate.
Oh yeah, if only he had the Orin ultimate. His ability should be back up fairly soon though. Could maybe look to go aggressively.
If he crashes this wave with the next, if Kage backs, that's pretty int. So hopefully he can keep him here under tower.
I think it's okay if Kage's forced to back, he'll lose a lot of CS. He doesn't really need to go for the kill. He's already ahead, and he'll outscale the Karma. Kage opting to freeze the wave, though. Well played. Never mind. Decides not to freeze the wave because he's killed too much minions, and... Okay, then.
It's doing something. I don't know if it's...
He is doing something. Terrain is taking the bluff.
Not a freeze.
He's taking
he's
the
not
bluff.
Shoving it.
He's taking the... What? I just... I don't know what's going on, but...
Yep.
All right, well, let's talk about mid lane now. Let's talk about mid lane now. I mean, okay, never mind. Gank bot lane happening. Bomb 3 ADC caught out. Vice putting him in, picks up the kill.
Hey, what did we say? Vineet right mid?
Yeah, Vineet's run mid. Vineet goes mid. Bomb 3 ADC gets caught. Pretty simple right there.
And they do burn Yone Flash right there with that good roam coming out from Bazillion.
Okay, Colma 25 is up here, although the solo kill might come down onto Kage. Never mind. There's a lot of healing coming in from the empowered root. But with Colma showing up top, that's a free dragon going over to the side of Name Pending, as Vice, Roland Chang, and Bode Kinkajou will pick that one up for the team. Getting the first drag on the table, Earth Drag coming up next, so we will see an Ocean or a Cloud Soul.
I definitely think Ocean Soul is obviously way more favorable for both of these teams, realistically.
Oh
I
yeah,
think
for
it
sure.
It does look way scarier on blue side than it does for red. But we will see what the dragon control looks like after this point.
Sivir, Relin, Taliyah with Cloud Soul is actually pretty scary. Taliyah can get a lot more ults off and start running you down with her throw another rock bullshit. Sivir pops the ultimate and like everyone gets a huge move speed boost. Rel ultimate can, you know, on a lower cooldown in general, huge team fighting ult. So it's pretty good overall. But yeah, I think everyone would still rather have Ocean Soul. So. But I think he'd be happy regardless. Yeah. Another gank coming in. Vice is here. Potentially maybe pick up a kill onto bottom 3 ADC or Blue Chez.
Ooh.
Ever. Forcing the flash away, Roland Chang with the Rel.
You do get a Dark Harvest proc over to Taliyah. And there's Brandon in the chat saying, just ulti away? Why flash? Man. I think he kind of had to flash that. I think he's talking about the Yone play.
Yeah.
I think...
He didn't need to flash. Yeah, if you ult, you can buffer away any CC and then you actually travel a further distance than flash, yeah. So
Well,
you'd have been fine if he ulted there.
I didn't know buffered the CC. I thought it could have been interrupted.
No, you can't interrupt you on ult.
Okay.
Well, like, once he's already started the channel, you can't interrupt it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Good to know. I do see Big Ichi around 9 CS a minute right now. Looking pretty good.
Yeah, Big Ichi is doing pretty well for himself. Up 30 CS on Josh. Terrain. Kage going aggressive onto Terrain here. Colma 25 is up top for a potential gank, but it doesn't work out. Just goes back.
Do you see
to
Rel
jungle.
Moving to the top side of the map here? Let's see if anything can get done from this, or if it's just going to be some
Big
vision
Ichi,
clearing.
Will he get stunned? No, he won't. Victor Gravity Field just barely walks out of there. I think he had like a millisecond left before that actually stunned him up.
And it looks like Zillion's also pathing mid, so both ADCs are going to be alone bot lane for a little bit, so don't know who's going to misplay that one into a kill for the other one. But
Big
Ichi we'll
going aggressive once again onto Raymate, dropped to half HP. There are a lot of people hovering mid, trying to relieve some pressure that Big Ichi is putting down onto a Raymate right now, but overall a really low kill game. This is quite a snooze fest compared to our last game, which was quite the banger. Several pop. They do notice Colma and Blue Chez up in the corner. Well played there. Preventing
absolutely
a gank.
Absolutely worth trading that.
No, yeah, for sure. It's like, okay, a Raymate. Is Big Ichi going to go for the Yone ult? I think he could have killed him there.
I think so, but... Well, he did know that their jungle mid were bot side.
I think it's a really quick assassination if that happens. And anyways, Rolchang going aggressive. Komal 25 pops the Olaf ult to run away from there. Vice goes in further with the Talia R. Just Q's forward. Flash is actually catches Blue Chez. However, the MF ult is dropped. Yone has come in with an excellent three-man ult. Blue Chez will be forced to pop the Zillion ult on himself to save his life. Roland Chang is going to die now. Komal 25 picks that one up with a stray undertow. Raymate putting down the Victor gravity field. So Rift Herald is dropped. Soon as you see Big Ichi go in for the Yone ult, immediately multiple TPs coming in from the side of the Wooper Syndicate. Very well coordinated return play there. Raymade kills off Bode Kinkajou, actually. I don't know why you stayed in the Victor laser, but okay, fine.
Yep, I think he spell shielded after he got hit with the first cast of it, and I don't think the spell shield blocks the second.
Here's the thing about the spell shield, right? The Victor laser travels in a line. So, like, if you spell shield the first part of the second cast, like, as long as you're still standing in it, you'll still get damaged by it.
Yeah.
Like, it's an AoE spell, right? It's an AoE spell that goes forward in a line, so... I mean, that's just not... It's just not it, Chief.
Yeah, I don't think that's the... Let's see if anything can happen here. It looks like Roland Chang might be caught out. Does manage to W away, and...
Why does he have Moby boots on Rel?
And why did they pop several ults for no reason? Oh, maybe a reason?
Okay, double bomb lands onto Big Ichi and Bode Kinkajou. There are no Yone ult in this fight right now. Or Rel ult. This is a huge int from Name Pending coming right here. Komal 25 just going to run down Bode Kinkajou, snipes him with the Olaf Axe as they leave, and the dragon is now on the table. Earth Drag going to be picked up for the Wooper Syndicate. Name Pending struggling quite a bit here. Okay, missing the Yone Q. Alright.
Good poke coming back out from the Victor. Let's take a look at gold really quickly. Looks like, regardless of the 35 farm difference looking in mid, they are even on gold. Just about, looks like a 10-15 gold difference between them. Jungle Kolma is up a 700 gold right now. In the jungle top lane, looks like Ornn is actually up by 300 gold, 80 carries. We have bottom three ADC up by 1700 gold in the bot lane, and 900 gold towards Vinit in the support lane, or roll rather.
Vice is up here for a gank onto Kage potentially. We could maybe see a dive happening. No one else is close by. I mean, you could just go. Kage is really low HP. I'm not too sure why he's backing. Wave's also pushed in with a cannon minion. I think,
well,
so
looking at red team's vision, I don't think they have vision on anybody on the map besides Kage at the moment, and their mid laner a few seconds ago, so I don't know if that was just a better safe than sorry kind of play. Or
I mean, I guess, but like at this point they're all here, and like the reason I say this is one of the biggest things that I think junglers lack in general in this tournament, like a lot of junglers, is no one really has a go button. Like, they just kind of sit there and just don't do anything, walk back and forth. Like, at some point you have to make a decision, right? Because it's better to try and fail than to do nothing. But, you know, anyways, Roland Chang gets blown up pretty much immediately, kind of beaten by Boris here with that Moby Boots coming in. Big Ichi, huge Yone, but I don't think it matters. He's caught in the middle of multiple people, and he is definitely going to go down here. Shield Boat is not going to save you, my friend. That is an angry Olaf running you down. Kagero picking up the kill. Credit for that one. 10-2 in the kills. Wooper Syndicate are absolutely demolishing Name Pending.
And there's the 5k gold lead right now at 17 minutes. I think this kind of just looks like GG. Feels like the rest of the game is going to be formalities at this point.
Yeah, probably.
I don't know if the game's going to go late enough for this... Saver is kind of looking like a component. Oh,
okay. Hey, Bode Kinkajou walking up into melee range of Victor and just getting one shot. That is the second time he has died through the spell shield, and you gotta realize, like, Victor Q, the empowered auto from Victor Q goes through spell shield. It's an auto attack, right?
Yep.
And I don't know. Second part of E also goes through spell shield.
But hey, if
Big Ichi is here, let's see if he's maybe able to pick up a shutdown onto Kolma.
Okay.
It's possible. Never mind, the Gore Drinker comes in and Kolma just heals up to half HP. Vice ends up dying. Kolma picking up a kill on Vice with the stray undertow. The things are just going wrong for these guys over and over again.
I don't think that was the worst play in the world from Red Team. Like, obviously it didn't go out the way they wanted to, but I think the concept behind it was good. They do kind of need to just go for desperation plays here. Try to swing a gold lead, try to swing a bounty back onto the Yone. I don't know if Sivir... this game's not going to go late enough for Lethality Sivir to really become a factor in this game to a point where it matters, but...
Yeah, for sure.
I think the idea and the concept of going for a desperation play like that, trying to get this Yone back into the game, trying to get to Leah, just a little bit more damage. A very preemptive Gale Force coming from the MF there, but maybe Roland Chang? Yeah, he's fine.
No, I don't think so. I mean, this is an extremely squishy Rell. He's opted to rush the Moby Boots before getting any armor item whatsoever, and Rell... The thing about Rell is she's not a champion that can, like, immediately benefit off of roaming simply because she doesn't have, like... If there's one thing that sets apart champions like Rell, Leon and Alistar to Rell, is that they have immediacy. Rell kind of doesn't. It's... You have to find, like, really interesting angles to prep your engages, and...
Yeah.
That's, like, the biggest difference, which is why I think Moby Boots really is never the move on Rell. Just go for something tanky. Like, it's not that big of a deal. You don't need to be roaming all the time.
Especially with that team. I think that team was just kind of meant to play for lane, just try to live till 15 minutes, nobody gets solo killed, and then you just go out and you have good team fights. But
right, exactly.
I don't think that communication factor came in at all. They got roamed on by their support, and I think Kage made a roam or two down to mid lane. The instant double TP coming from that original first team fight, just things like that, just weren't really matched or responded to well by Red Team.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, like, Roland Chang also did kind of like just sort of sit in lane a lot of the game, so it's also like another thing why the Moby Boots weren't working out for him. At that point, just get like Tabbies or Merc Treads, or like even get Swifties or something. Like,
Can we please acknowledge the Zillion's build at the moment? The triple Kindle Gem, double Control Ward.
I got a Thief's Edge. Can someone screenshot that and at Vineet once the game is done, please? Somebody please screenshot that. Vineet almost to Kindle Gem Exodia. True.
That is a sight to behold. You see the Moonstone and Staff of Flowing Water already finished up top lane, and a 6-stack Darksteel over for Kageru.
4 Kindle Gem! Wait, Vineet's a madman. 4 Kindle Gem Zillion, bro. Wait, dude, this guy's just a madman. Holy shit.
He's fucking here. Freaking here.
Never mind. He sold his 4th Kindle Gem for Control Wards. SMH, Vineet. How dare you?
Did it for the content.
Yeah, he did it for the content. Four Kindle Gems is the correct build, which is the funny part. Interesting. Do you just rush ability haste or something and just always have your bombs up, always have your move speed up? Whatever is the case, Bluchez is going crazy with it.
Interesting Talia wall coming out mid. Didn't look like it caged anybody off, so just a failed attempt there.
Going aggressive onto terrain right now. Wooper Syndicate currently sporting a 5,000 gold lead, forced to flash away from the Victor gravity field.
And Lucidity, says chat. Well, we
that's a lot of damage onto Bode Kinkajou. Okay, Kolma, they're trying to catch Kolma, but you forget he's got a Starex. You forget he has a Gore Drinker. You forget he has a Zillion behind him. You are not killing this Olaf. Goodbye, Roland Chang. There was an attempt, but sadly the attempt was, it was a failed attempt. Terrain, going for the 1v1 under tower against the Victor, but it doesn't matter. Big Ichi going aggressive onto Blue Chest, picking up the kill. Fortunately, not a shutdown, but you know, you have to say, I take those. Colma 25, getting insane speed boost from Kage. Karma Olaf combination is unbelievable. He's just running them down over and over again. 6-0-4 on the Olaf. This is just this is literally just support the Olaf team comp, straight up.
Yep. And Victor doing his best up top lane, tried to kill the Ornn under tower, but flashed the R really fairly well, but he did end up just not being able to put out that damage just yet. And Ornn gets to walk away with about 50 HP.
And yeah, I think this game is just, it's been closed out for a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, they outscale on the side of, I mean, Victor definitely scales really well. Hold on.
Let me not. Bot lane in loser's queue. Okay, man. Let me not say anything too quickly. This is VCU LCS, and we have seen teams throw a bigger lead than this.
We definitely have.
Wancheng walking away with just a little bit of HP left.
For
Mortar
sure.
Mortar reminder is second. You hate to see it.
I mean, he's kind of forced into it at this point. That's just so much healing coming from the Olaf. And, you know, when an Olaf is running at you head first, killing all your carries, like, he's kind of become the main focus, you know. But, hey, if Big Ichi's able to get an ult off and kill three people at once, that could turn the tides of the game. We have seen Big Ichi do some crazy things before. It's on him to,
Hey. I've heard the running jokes of the Sivir Elo terrorist strategy, but I didn't think they were this real. This is quite the unfortunate sequence.
Sivir is an Elo terrorism champion, but so is Roland Chang's Rao. Raymane is an Elo terrorist, actually, but forget. Oh. Never mind. Boat Kinkajou just dies once again.
And the Victor ult, can it save him?
Shutdown going over to Vice in this case, but now Big Ichi is forced to flash away from Angry Colma. Roland Chang gets killed by Blue Chez. I mean,
very, very, very interesting.
I felt like Violance was the answer, says Araymate.
He did go really hard that whole fight.
Big Ichi going in aggressively onto the team, gets the shield bow, but it doesn't matter. Colma 25 dunks him down with the true damage, is godlike on the Olaf. This is just disgusting, I mean, to watch, man. Just Zillion and Karma just perma buffing Olaf all the time. Like, it's gross. And once these guys get Cloud Soul, just watching Olaf run at people with like 1.2k move speed is going to be hilarious.
Yeah, I hope the game's not going to go that far, but
for sure. But you know, Red Lightning says it the best here. Free Big Ichi. Free Big Ichi from this hell. Free him.
He's trying his best.
Mid lane, good role. The individual skill of these mid laners matter. True. You know, Brandon has been talking about how bad mid lane is, and if people don't want to believe it, then you can just take a look at this game for proof. I mean, Big Ichi was kind of gapping Josh in lane, but did it matter? Absolutely not, because when you have a Olaf that's buffed by a Karma and a Zillion, like, what's a Yone gonna do?
Do you see one of the Kindle gems getting finished into a Shirelia's battle song?
The other Kindle gem is gonna get finished into a Black Cleaver, because it is Black Cleaver that's University.
Yep, that's what we're hoping for. Feels bad to be name pending. I actually think they could win some games if they didn't play Crusader/Wooper first.
I mean,
I guess, like, I don't know. This is kind of what we were talking about at the beginning of the game. Yes, red team is obviously favored in the drafts. Like, on paper, their team fight looks really good. And even when that Yone got caught out by Olaf a little while ago, it definitely looks like their team fight has so much potential, but at this point in the game they're just so far behind, and I think a lot of that just came from early game communication errors and just like good flash coming out from the Karma, and looks like
Kagero just
nothing
barely
comes
living
out of that
with a sliver of HP. I mean, The thing is, I don't think anyone can match Big Ichi in the side lane at the moment, so I think it's okay for him to stay there, but
yeah.
The question stands, right? Like, if you're Whoopers, at what point do you just, like, tell the Karma, hey, TP up, let's just buff Kolma again and have Kolma run everyone down, right? And, you know, they're going towards the Baron right now. Big Ichi is continuing to push, although Big Ichi does have teleport. He is going to TP in. He could maybe see a Karma TP to follow.
Karma should match it in just a few seconds, but it looks like Blue Team's just disengaging.
I don't know why they're opting to disengage here when they can just have Karma TP up and buff Olaf and just run everyone down.
I think this is actually beneficial for them.
Wait, how so?
I think Blue Team's just going to do the same thing they just did, but in like two more minutes, and Dione's going to be caught splitting bot without TP.
I mean, fair enough, but we do see Victor TPing up there, looking for a flank angle, but...
Red team's just all walking down. I think they saw it.
They probably did see it, yeah. Roland Chang bound to Big Ichi here.
Can they
see
that?
That's a lot of damage onto a Raymate. I don't think you can see they can see the bind through the ward, but I could be mistaken on that one.
Ignite or exhaust game for Yone, TP with this comp is grief. Yeah, but, like, it's VCLCS, you know? What do you expect?
I'm getting sleepy,
I don't... I feel that, man. It's been quite the day. But I don't think, I can't speak. I just looked at the wrong thing. I don't think double TP is awful. But at the same time, they do have a very, like... kind of... What's the word? Like, instant kind of team fight? Like, it's a very, like, spontaneous team fight, and having teleports for those isn't going to be the best. You kind of just want, situational. Like, you see those people grouped up, you need to rel ult immediately, follow with Ornn, follow with Yone. And if you have TPs, you kind of eliminate some of the possibilities to do those.
Yeah,
at the same time, this is a competitive, air quotes, competitive situation.
Air quotes, competitive situation. Yeah,
where you do want good map pressure. And not at all what the red team is doing right now, letting lots and lots of minions die in the bot lane for absolutely no one to collect the golden XP.
I mean...
It looks like it's actually... I can't really tell. Let me pan over. It's slow pushing towards them. Hopefully someone will catch before he hits the tower.
I feel like Big Ichi should probably go catch that. I mean, I don't see anyone else.
I think most resources should be funneled towards Talia and Yone at this point in the game.
No, yeah, for sure. Bone Kinkajou is like a glorified minion. He's a glorified caster minion.
Yeah.
And Roland Chang is...
I think, this is an old item for me, but granted, I'm a fairly new player.
Decent Rao ultimate to start off the fight, but, like, Kolma 25 just pops the ult, all the buffs coming in. Doesn't really matter. Raymate just one-shots Bone Kinkajou as a, you know, terrain. He is decently tanky, but, like, how much longer can he hold out? Big Ichi gets absolutely blown up, evaporated by the Victor. Shut down going in.
Big Ichi did his job really well that fight, though, I think.
He did. He did kill off bottom 3 ADC.
He killed bottom 3 ADC, and he 1v2'd off Karma. Oh my god, they're letting Vice go absolutely
gets
crazy.
A kill onto... Will he get the kill onto Kage? Wait a minute. Does Kage... Okay, never mind. Shutdown goes over to Blue Chez. Double bomb coming in really quickly. Wow. Things looked a little bit iffy. Vice almost world starred them, but it don't matter. This is going to be the Cloud Soul coming in. But the thing is, like, here's my thought. If their bot lane was, like, not so far behind, this could be a lot more even than it looks, right?
Right.
Because, like, Roland Chang and Bode Kinkajou just don't exist. This is a 3v7 at the 3v7 at the moment.
Imagine if they were even. We're trying to imagine, I promise.
We're trying to imagine. And
okay, I don't know. I really want to see.
No, Roland Chang! Holy shit.
Not to the dragon? Okay. I really wanted to see Sivir Q damage this game, but I don't think I've had the opportunity to.
The thing about Lethality Sivir is you can stay away in range and, like, Q people, but Bode Kinkajou's walking up melee range of a Raymate to get an auto attack in. Like, that's not how you play Lethality Sivir. You spam your Q off cooldown from distance.
What I meant by Big Ichi did a decent job that team fight, obviously, yes, he inted to two of them in the back line, but he did hold Kage and Victor, like, off of that fight for a decent amount of time, let Vice pick up the kills onto Olaf, let Vice pick up the kills onto I think he killed Olaf and bottom three ADC in that fight.
Yeah, I mean, we do see Wisher in the chat saying this is the best Cloud Soul team. It actually is. Olaf, Victor, Karma, Zillion. I mean, the only person that doesn't benefit is bottom three ADC, but like, that does that really matter when you have Kolma just running people down? He's three items. He's got Gordrinker, he's got Starix, he's got Death Stance. Like, no one's going to be stopping this Olaf.
Yeah, the MF at this point in the game is kind of like the, what's the best way to put it? It's like when you go to the library and there's that really ripped up book in the corner, but they just keep it there anyways.
Yeah.
It's kind of like that.
I like the analogy. Roland Chang missing the rel ulti. Oh no, that's not good. He's probably going to die here since he's so squishy on the rel. Raymade going aggressive onto Vice. The Zillion ult is down. The Chaos Storm is still ripping through everyone. Double kill goes through for the Victor. Terrain lands the point blank ult shutdown going over to the Ornn, but it doesn't matter. He is dead anyways. Bottom three ADC picking up the kill credit on that one. Big Ichi is nowhere to be found in the fight. He probably got zoned off from it. Boat Kinkacho the same.
He ulted into two people and then saw an Olaf behind them and immediately took his Eve back. So.
Yeah, I mean, I would too if I was him.
Imagine if Redside ever hit their CC, like, once. That's what I'm saying, man. I just want to see Sivir Q damage, but I haven't been able to see it all game, man. Oh, yet again, can't even see it on the Baron.
I mean, it's not even doing that much.
Oh, there it is. It did a little bit to bottom 380.
Just a tad. I mean, dude, I just... 075, 071... It ain't it, Chief. It just ain't.
Free Big Ichi in the chat, please.
Can we get a free Big Ichi in the chat?
He's trying his hardest. Still leading the game in CS.
This is domestic terrorism. I keep seeing a Rel Sivir Yone combo in my head. It's not going to happen this game, just saying. It just isn't.
Josh in the chat, Ichi battle bot lane right now, we duel.
I mean, let's move over to the bot lane, see what happens. We don't need to see the rest of the team. We just need to see Big Ichi versus Josh.
Blue team sieging. It is just regular team things. We'll see what happens here. Both mid laners level 17 in the game at this point. Do see 3.5 items onto the Victor and 3 items onto Yone.
Are they going to catch out Big Ichi here? Let's see.
Oh.
Yeah, I mean, he ulted out, so it's whatever.
And blue team making really good use of their Baron here, sieging mid, sieging bot, both tier 2s. We'll see if they can maybe grab an inhibitor off of this. We do have a minute and a half left on Baron. A good
Indeed,
Talia
we
ult
do. Decent rel ult to bring a Raymate, but it doesn't matter. He's kind of tanky, actually. Bottom 3 ADC kills off Roland Chang. Kolma's an absolute madman. You see that movement speed coming in.
That
Misfortune ult
speed.
Kills off both Sivir and Yone from Ooh. Over the wall. Triple kill for bottom 3 ADC.
Wait.
Will they make it a quadra kill here with the kill onto Terrain? Flashes away. Undertow lands. Will this be quadra kill? Bottom 3 ADC's unstoppable. Unofficial quadra. Where are they going to go for the unofficial penta shutdown? Never mind. They're inting it all over to Vice. But he just barely lives with 1 HP. As bottom 3 ADC types in chat, cowards. True.
Absolutely crazy. And blue team just sealing out the game here, looks like it.
Yeah, blue team's just kind of running away with the game. I mean, it's over here. Vice trying to save the game, but it doesn't matter. Kolma just has too much shields, too many heals. He's so unbelievably fed. Roland Chang dies once more, 09-1 on the scoreboard. That is not it, Chief. GG's to Wooper Syndicate. Let's see if we can get in someone for an interview here. I will put out a poll.
That game was over long ago? Yeah, we know. But hey, it is what it is. Let's check out damage charts for just a second. They deserve to lose that game for not giving Pensa. Well, Vidi, I don't know if you're paying attention, but they lost the game.
All right, let's start this poll up. Let's see who we can get in for the interview. And meanwhile, while that's happening, I will reward the winners with channel points. Choose outcome. Wooper Syndicate wins. Would be nice if I could see stats and show to the stream, but...
Oh, I have them up, but I don't. Yep.
I can screen share it to you, I guess.
And then you can show it. That's kind of scuffed. Man, I don't want to do that. Ugh. We'll just skip the stats and jump straight into the interview. How about that?
Word.
I think that's a.
I can. Yeah. Chant with me. Blue Jazz.
But yeah, that team was. Red team put up a fight, but there's not really much you can do. I think blue team just plays as a unit consistently. We see that basically every one of their games, their movements on the map are just very synchronized and such.
All right, looks like we're going to be pulling in Vinit for the interview. Let's see. Where is it?
I already know what I'm asking him.
I mean,
why didn't he commit to the four Kindle gems, man?
Move to Vinit.
Hello.
Welcome Yo. To the interview. Congrats on your dominating victory over name pending and going in a draft quickly before Praneeth asks his questions. Were you guys going for the second you saw Olaf left open for Kolba, were you guys like, all right, it's over. We're doing a buff Kolba comp.
I'm going to do this again. I might regret it again, but ban Koma's Olaf, guys. How are you so delusional that you think you can win against Koma's Olaf? That's crazy. All right, whatever.
All right, Vinny, I have a question.
Yeah.
I don't know when it was in the game, but we saw your build change to the four Kindle gems, and you were about to leave your base, and you opted back, and you went back to three Kindle gems in the control wards. Why did you not give the people what they wanted?
So I would have gone for Kindle gem if this was solo queue, but I needed to get vision for my team, so I had to get the control ward. But that build, no matter what anyone says, I was talking to Tempos, and that build is so OP because you get 40% CDR at 15 minutes. A zillion ult with 40% CDR at 15 minutes. How crazy is that?
Yeah, no, you did work that game. Even when Josh was just walled off by the Talia, he kind of just started running around like a race car and just couldn't get hit by anything. Got the zillion ult preemptively,
Now that we're on the topic of Josh, I got some exposing to do. We could have ended this game like 10 minutes earlier, but all Josh is saying in comms is, I want a battle. I want a battle. And he kept going to mid lane and running it into them because he wanted to battle.
That's the classic Josh we love.
Dude, I mean, just wants to prove he's better than Big Ichi, but sadly that's not the case. Big Ichi is obviously best mid VCU, true. AKA Dio Brandon. Okay, would you agree that Big Ichi needs to be freed from the shackles of name pending?
They honestly didn't play that bad. I'm not gonna lie. Their ballin kind of ran it down, okay, but Vice Lelele was playing pretty well.
Vice played well. I think Vice played well. Yeah.
I don't think Tony did bad either.
How about a free the top side?
Free
of name...
top side for sure. Free top
free
side.
The top side of
okay,
name
free
pending.
Free top side. Any thoughts or advice to any more Lethality Sivir players that want to bust it out for
BCS? It's bait. It's good for solo queue because you can spike really fast, really early, but it's bait. Stick to crit.
Yeah, that didn't look like that was the play.
This is for Koma. He told me to flame Brandon. So Brandon, you suck. 0-2. Worse than sniped.
Go ahead. Whoa!
Okay. Kolba coming in with the fire. Oh my god. Y'all, I understand Olaf got banned, but do you think they just forgot about it?
I think they were trying to bait us into the Talia Olaf Talia matchup because Talia actually doesn't do too bad into Olaf. As long as she has phase rush, she can actually match him in fights, and she has a faster clear overall. They did a pretty good job of this. His pathing was a little weird. Kind of felt like he was tunneled on trying to put bot behind, so didn't actually path for highest gold, which is kind of shitty on Talia, honestly. But he did pretty well.
Fair enough.
Yep.
Well, smart insight coming in from our very own resident head coach of VCU Gold. Congrats on the victory, moving up to 2-0 to join the likes of the very sultry Kings and Dogecoin to the moon. What are your thoughts going into your next week matchup? Let me just pull that up really quickly.
Who will be against?
Yeah, let me pull it up. I don't even know myself, but I'll know shortly enough. You guys are against the boys, Elvin's team. What are your thoughts going into that?
That one's going to be a banger.
For sure.
It's going to be a lot of fighting.
Wait, who are you playing?
He's playing Elvin's team.
Oh, Lord. That one's going to be a good game.
But it's going to be a banger.
A lot of confidence coming out. The boys have shown that they're not just a bottom tier team, as some people did put them there, but they have showed a decent amount of performance this season. But we're looking forward to that next week. We have
better players in every role. I'm just going to say it. So,
No, I do see from your team. Obviously, I mean, I think even you can admit this. I think that Red Team's team fight draft was a lot better, like on paper. Obviously, your players played the role.
Yes, and we pretty much just
a lot differently.
We went into that game pretty much just like buffed Olaf. Let's just like call McCary, and that's what happened.
I mean, yeah, y'all definitely did let Colma carry picking the Carbatop and the Zillion, man. Once that Cloud Soul landed, just watching Colma run around with 1,000 move speed was, man, that was some fear right there. I could feel the sweat on a Big Ichi's eyebrows. But
yeah, he was trying. He did good in lane, but
he got away. Team gap hit is what it is. He got away. I played Zillion. Next time I'll play something like in Roman. He'll have the time of his life.
Me and Lokesh did have a prediction in during the spectator delay that when you hit level 3 and roamed mid, bottom 3 ADC would get caught up and die. But and that definitely did happen.
It was close. It was level 5.
He did go from looking like a non-factor on his team and then scoring a triple kill, even out damaging the Olaf. Put in a lot of work this game.
Yeah, Kyle played really well.
Yep.
Well,
I think
they didn't give us a pen. That's what we're mad at.
Oh, yeah.
But whatever.
Scumbag name pending. The guys will get the Penta next time. It is what it is, though. Congrats on the victory, Vanid. Glad to see y'all are succeeding. And I think I am looking forward to matching up with Wooper Syndicate in the future. Although we were probably going to get trashed.
What are you talking about? We're both 2-0 teams.
We're both 2-0 teams, but I'm an 8th place team, right?
I don't care. You said it.
Hey, I put your team higher. I'm just saying.
I'm an 8th place team. Ahead of Washington Everfrost, though, for sure.
Listen. We're sandbagging early. It's all strategy. It's a mental game.
You're sandbagging.
Sandbagging early by picking Ezreal, Lulu, and Garen.
Hey, I just follow the directions of my captain. You guys can question Lord Wisher in the chat about that. That's not on me, guys.
Colma in the chat. Oh my god. Well, anyways, thanks for everyone tuning into the stream. Glad y'all joined us for this doubleheader VCU LCS games. We'll be back sometime whenever the next week games get scheduled. Peace out.